Yeah, good day to everybody. I am Dr. H.S. Nanda. My contact details: mobile number 9845655234. Mail ID principal@bti.bangalore.org. Coming to my academic qualifications, I completed bachelor's in engineering with civil engineering specialization in 1986 from Malnad College of Engineering, Hassan. M.Tech civil engineering in 1993 from Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay. PhD in civil engineering in 2007 from Bangalore University. Coming to my experience, I started my career from Malnad College of Engineering as lecturer about 2 years. Then I worked in KVG College of Engineering for 13 plus years, from 88 to 2001. At different levels, as lecturer, assistant professor, and professor, along with administrative post, HOD also. Then I joined Nagarjuna College of Engineering in the year 2001 and worked for about 10 years as assistant professor, professor, along with administrative post HOD of civil engineering. And in 2007, I was promoted as given responsibility of heading the institution and worked for 4 years. Then I joined Bangalore Technological Institute in 2011, and till date I am working as principal. I put around 8 plus years at Bangalore Technological Institute. Briefly, my achievements: I have published 50 technical papers in national and international seminars, conference, and journals. I attended about 60 seminar, conference, workshops, and organized more than 70 seminar, conferences, workshop, and I guided 40 plus UG projects and 10 PG projects, and guided 3 PhD candidates. I am a life membership of Indian Geotechnical Society, life member of ISTE, life member of Institution of Engineers. Now, I have assigned to give online classes on Module 5 in the subject Analysis of Determinate Structures. The topic that it will be covered in Module 5 are arches and cable structures. Coming to the arches. Now, you might have seen in many civil engineering structures, these arches. Why these arches? If you take a beam, for a simple ideal case, subjected to UDL throughout. We know the Venn moment diagram will be a parabola with its maximum Venn moment at the mid-span because of symmetry. And if you draw shear force diagram, maximum at the support and zero at the mid-span. That means the load will be transferred through bending and through shear to the support points. Respectively, there will be bending stress and shear stress. Any horizontal beam, if you take, it will be designed for maximum bending moment and for maximum shear stress. The maximum bending moment will be occurring only at one point here, or it may be one or two points depending upon the different types of loads. Similarly, shear force. But by taking the maximum bending moment or maximum shear force, the beam will be designed. If you design for a maximum bending moment, the cross section of the beam that we provide will be same throughout. But this cross section of the beam is to withstand this maximum bending moment, whereas it is reducing if you go towards the support, but we are providing the same cross section. That means unnecessarily we are putting the materials here. That too, if the span is very large or for longer span, this again the material involved here to resist the smaller bending moment will be more. In addition, the self weight of the beam also will cause lot of bending moment if the span is large or length of the beam is large. Similarly, for the shear force also, here only the shear force is maximum. It will be designed for maximum shear stress. But when we go near here, that much cross section or the detailings are not required here. Now, to make this economical, there was a solution. It is by making a curved beam. That is like this. For a longer span, therefore, okay. If we provide arches like this, a curved beam, the loads coming on the arch will be transferred to the support through or along the axis of the arch. That in turn will reduce the bending moment, and hence the cross-sectional dimension required will be very less as compared to the horizontal beam, especially for the longer span. Therefore, to make it economical, curved beams are provided, nothing but arches. That is, arches are provided like this. Coming to the different nomenclature in arches, the distance between the two supports is called as span, and the vertical height to which the arch is raised from the support points is called rise. The point to which it is raised is called crown, and the arch is supported, it is called abutment. Now it can be supported on the intermediate piers also, and these are also called springings. Coming to the forces on arches, if you consider any section in the arch, the load will be transferred to the support points along the axis of the arch, and it is called normal thrust. And a force which acts normal to the axis of the arch is called radial shear, Q or F, and a body moment M. Most of the load is transferred through normal thrust, that is along the axis of the arch. The magnitude of the body moment will be less. Therefore, cross section of the beam or arch required will be less. Now, there are different types of arches. We'll see the classification. Classification is based on